Let's take a closer look at AZCopy, and this is a command line utility that you can use to copy blobber files to or from a storage account. So the first thing you're going to need is the executable file, and there you can see they have it for Windows, Linux, and Mac. And then once you download that file, what you're going to have to do is also make sure that you have the right level of authorization with for the user account they're using with it. So you might need to, for download, you'll need storage blob data reader, for upload, storage blob data contributor, and storage blob data owner. So just be aware that you need to have those roles available to you to your user account. I think that I have access to everything, so I don't think I set this. It just works. But if you're in a larger company and you have more least permissive roles, you just need to know about that. And so you can gain access via either the Azure Active Directory or a shared access signature. So let's just take a look at that right now. So the idea here is that we'll type in AZCopy login, and this is going to ask us whether we want to sign into the web browser. So that is that should be Azure Active Directory option one. And so what you'll do is you'll enter your username and password, and you'll then have to enter the code displayed there. And so now you're ready to use the CLI. And so all you have to do is type in AZCopy, copy, and then you have the file, and then you give it the endpoint to the storage account and the container and the location you want it to go in. If you want to download files, it's the same command. You just reverse the order. You say, this is the location of the file, and I want to download it locally. All right.